Holy Spirit, we just welcome you here tonight. We pray that you would make for yourself a place where you can move, where you can come and minister without feeling rushed. This would be your dwelling place. As we let go of all our distractions, all our escapes, all the things that we turn to, we just allow ourselves to sit here in your presence. Pray that you would be pleased, you'd be delighted, that tonight would be about you, about seeing you for who you are, about seeking you first. We thank you, Holy Spirit, that you want to move here tonight. That as much as we come into this place with anticipation and longing and desire, you meet us in this place with even greater longing, even greater desire to move in our midst. We don't force you to do anything. We simply surrender here in your presence, and we ask that you would have your way in us. We love you, Holy Spirit.
Spirit of the living God. You said that you would fall. Thank you.
I stray.
Oh, Jesus, the image of
song my soul can find to sing. For holy is the Lord revealed before my eyes, and my burning heart can scarcely take it in. As I behold your beauty with unworthy eyes, and the only song my soul can find to sing is hallelujah, 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 my King, hallelujah. Thank you.
Myself.
precious blood than my Jesus spill. Now the curse of sin has no hold on me, whom the Son sets free, all is free.
Thank you.
and women who are strong and steadfast in their faith and who are mature in Christ. Strengthen these pastors with the word of God. God, supernaturally put Bibles in their hands and hide these Bibles from the eyes of their persecutors. Give them grace to get a hold of your word and to find time and space to read your word. God, as they go deep into the word, Holy Spirit, reveal the truth to them. Lord, train them in the word of God and increase the anointing upon their Bible study. Father, give these pastors wisdom to know how to pastor their flock in the midst of wolves. Speak to them and reveal to them when they should hold church services and when they shouldn't. When they do these services, I ask that your presence would be thick and that the fire of God would fall. Lord, as these pastors pray and seek your face, expand their vision of the great things that you are doing in North Korea and give them hope as they pastor their people and pray for their nation. Within them, that no matter what, that they would know that God has not abandoned them, and they would know that, God, they are more than conquerors and that nothing can separate them from your love. I just release fresh grace over their minds and their hearts to be renewed in the truth. I declare depression has no place in the minds of your saints. Hopelessness must go. It has no place in the minds of your saints or in their hearts. I take up my authority in Christ, and I declare prison doors being opened for your saints. I declare liberty over your sons and daughters. I declare liberty over Pastor Hyung Soo Lim. I declare liberty in Jesus' name. Let's pray.
Thank you. the North Korean church as a church that never leaves you, her first love. I release grace over the church to count everything as loss and not to look back or to regret. Cause them to live by your word and keep it until the day that Jesus returns. I declare that the church is the hope for North Korea, that the church will be the ones to see their nation delivered of idolatry, that they will be the ones to witness the implosion of the Kim dynasty, and that they will see North and South Korea becoming one again. I ask that their patient endurance will be a shining example for the rest of the world, and that when Jesus returns, that he will receive a glorious bride in the church. Let's pray. Thank you.
I won't.
we lift our eyes to you. Our help comes from the Lord and the Lord alone. We thank you that this is our confession. Whether in plenty or in hunger, abundance or in need, we know that we have an all-sufficient Savior. We have everything that we need in you. May this be the confession of the saints that are currently in North Korea as well. That you are everything that they need. That your grace is sufficient for them. Through every instance of hardships and persecution, their joy, their delight, their reward, their prize is in you. May they press on, leaving everything else behind. May they press on towards the upward call of Christ Jesus, their Lord and their Savior. May they experience no lack in any and every circumstance. For you are the God who provides for them, and you are the God who's faithful. Faithful to his promises, faithful to his covenant. Thank you for all these things. We pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Thank you for joining us tonight. We hope that you are blessed tonight, and that as we lifted up the church in North Korea, that you felt really power going out as we're praying on behalf of brothers and sisters who are currently facing persecution and hardships. Pray that this was a time in which your heart for the things that are in God's heart also grew, and your vision for God's kingdom, for God's beauty and for his glory also grew throughout tonight. So we pray that you guys continue to have a wonderful rest of the night, a wonderful weekend as well. We'll see you guys next week. Next week, we have a Wednesday morning watch at 9:30 in the morning. And on Thursday, it's a day off. It's Children's Day here in Korea. We're still going to hold our Thursday night watch. So we hope to see you there, here. We hope to see you here at 8 p.m. next Thursday as well. Have a wonderful rest of the night.
Joke.